soon left the church. Well, good evening, welcome, and welcome to a much later community update and prayer. Bishop Desmond, Vision Temple of Praise, and I just want to greet you in the mighty name of our Lord and Savior, Jesus Christ. Today, I visited my GP, and we were talking, and one of the things she said, I noticed that I've never seen my GP surgery in 30 years, and I go to Lorry Pike Health Centre in Fentham Road, Aston. I have never seen that GP surgery so empty. No one in at all, just me. Saw other people coming along after. But importantly, they said they've just upgraded lighting, had it painted, as many people have done during COVID, and said they've got the screens ready to get it back up and running. And then she said the COVID figures have gone up, so they're having to rethink what they're doing. And coupled with that is the talk of this new COVID variant as well. COVID variant is called COVID-22. A super variant, they're calling this. And remember as well, we've got the Delta variant. And we've also now got the UK... the UK red list, which has been updated as well to include places such as St. Lucia, Jamaica and Dominica, for example, as well. So clearly a lot of things happening there with COVID-19. But on a local front, so, you know, the trend is we're not out of the woods yet, I'm afraid. Now, the trends are at the moment COVID cases. So looking at the COVID cases, Yardley was the highest in Birmingham last week. Sutton, Trinity, Perry Common, King's Standing, Bartley Green, frankly, Hyters Heath, that's Kings Norton Way, Kings Norton itself, Garrett's Green and South Yardley. Now, cases increased in all age groups this week, which is of concern because, you know, it means it's just going right across the board now. And cases decreased in all ethnic groups, most undoubtedly the mixed and other groups. That went down by 34%. But new cases of COVID-19 this week, now that's down 3,495 compared to 3,674 last week. Now the rate of cases are down as well, 306. Testing is also down, 5,402. Now, what the head of the GP practice told me today was this. The uptake in particular parts of the inner city area, such as Newtown, such as Lascelles and Aston, the actual uptake of COVID-19 vaccinations is not hitting the target yet. However, this is what was of extreme concern. There are people with COVID symptoms who potentially have COVID-19 who are not getting tested. Now, all right, if it's the case that you don't want to have the vaccination for whatever reason, then if you're showing symptoms of COVID-19, is it not at least the right thing to do to get tested? That's all I'm going to say to you. Because COVID-19 cases are on the rise, but testing is down. Now, I myself at home, I've had my two vaccinations, but we have tests here that at least if you feel you need to have a test, you have it and do it at home first. Based on that result you have at home, you may then have to go to the GP or get a PCR test done rather. Order your PCR test, get that done. So clearly, And this is the point I'm making. Let's be responsible with what we're doing. We're not just talking about you and what, however you want to see things, or me rather, and I want to see things. Let's just be fair and reasonable in what we're doing. That's the point I'm making. So at the end of the day, if we are going to combat COVID and win, get the ultimate victory and whip COVID, as it were, we all have our roles to play. That's the point I'm making to you. So clearly, we have to be sensible with this. So this week, PCR total tests are 15%, down 15.5%. So it's a little less than last week. Now, importantly, the point that we're going to make is this. Think carefully. Many of us are sending around these videos of all the conspiracy theories, and some will say to me, well, look, what you're talking about as well is conspiracy theories. The point is this. Why send round stuff to discourage people? Send round information where people can make informed decisions, please. That's all I say. That's all I ask. Informed decisions. And I will tell you, I've had my two vaccinations. Okay? I know of many people who have now had COVID and they have said, I am going to get my vaccination because it was horrible. Some people say it's a myth. Whichever side of the coin you're on, all I'm going to say to you is this. Remember, it's not just you alone in this big wide world that we're in. There are other people. And at a time when, you know, the Caribbean islands now are going to our red list, I know people right now who are in the Caribbean. I know people right now who are in Dominica. I know people right now who are in Jamaica. And once Jamaica goes into that red zone, and Dominica and St. Lucia, many of the other countries, what that means is you have to quarantine in a hotel. That's what it means, compounds. So clearly, you have to think about the implications of what you decide to do. And that's all I'm saying. And it's far easier to call it how it is than anything else. So let's moving forward. Let's think carefully. COVID is here for a while. And let's be as sensible as we can. You know, we hear all these things about water being in vaccination needles, people are being vaccinated with saline. Look, at the end of the day, I can tell you this. In the 18 months since lockdown, I have not had COVID. I've had my two vaccinations and I'm still here to tell the story. The point I'm making is this. Not everyone has the same experience. Before I had my vaccinations, I asked questions. I made sure I did. I'm a diabetic as well. I've got high blood pressure. I'll share that with you. And I did ask questions because I had my concerns just like the next person. And I made my decision for me. Many people said you shared your decision, so it wasn't just your decision, you made a decision for others. No, I'm not. I'm telling you my experience to encourage you to think for yourself. Okay, so that's COVID-19. Now, many of you would have seen a petition regarding a 74-year-old man. He's a cancer sufferer. His name is Lewin. And there's a petition going around which has been signed by many people asking for him to remain in the UK. The Home Office has issued him with a deportation notice. He's been in the UK for 18 years. All I'll ask you to do is this. It's a petition's entitled Let Lewin Stay. Have a look at it. I've seen some people with some critical comments. Okay. It's 68,950 signatures today. We're just looking it up. One thing I'm going to say to you, and it's called Let Lewin Stay, and it's at change.org. One thing I'm going to say to you is this. It's easy to criticize. And many people who live in glass houses, you know, don't chuck stones. None of us are perfect. And when we've got a brother or a sister in distress, let's deal with that. Now, some will say, listen, there are too many of our brothers and sisters in distress. But the point is this, irrespective of how many there are, in or out of distress, one of the main things we've got to do is remember we should be there for each other. And that's the important thing. And as we look at what's happening in our lives today, some will say, well, I'm British, I've got a British passport, it's not me, and it won't be me. But it could be a cousin, it could be a relative of some sort. When it comes knocking at your door or your family's door, then it may well be your problem. So let's rally around our brother Lewin, 74 years old. He's got lymphoma and he is just to let you know, I spoke to him today and he's not in a very good place with cancer. With cancer, and obviously he's been treated, but his prognosis can only improve whilst he's here in the UK. And we have to, for humanity's sake, let us support this cause. Let us get this petition over the 100,000 mark. Now, something else I want to talk about tonight. We've seen various pieces of publicity, and I'll be writing an article on this next week, where many companies, truck companies say we're short of truck drivers. We've got meatpacking industry saying we're short of people, packers, talking about having the prison service recommence day release for prisoners to come and assist. Why don't the government... All these people, they say, we don't know how many people are here illegally, but the government, why don't the government give some people even interim leave to remain, limited leave to remain, place them on a pathway? You know, you've been in the country, say, 10 years, no criminal record. Come on, get those people stay regularized so they can pick up and fulfill these empty posts that industry is talking about. Come on, we can do that, can't we? Let's be practical. You know, get people learning to drive, get them licensed up. You know, come on, we got enough people here to do this. But instead of that, we're talking about a hostile environment when we're short, when we've got labor shortages. Come on, let's think carefully. What we're doing, because I don't think there's enough careful thought going on, in all honesty. Now, in the few minutes we've got left, I want to talk about the fact that a few months ago we started a community forum in Lascelles, and we're pleased to say one's been formed in Burberry Park, another one has been formed in St. George's Estate in Newtown. The Central Newtown Community Forum is coming on board as well, and we got one in South Aston. And then there's one for North Aston as well. And this is now spreading and people are now finally wanting to get involved and have their voices heard about how their communities are functioning. And importantly, they want to get involved to hold authorities to account regarding policing, regarding the fire service, regarding rubbish, regarding parks, regarding housing, even regarding parking. The next community forum meeting is for people in South Aston, which is on the 1st of September at 7 p.m. at the United Reformed Church in Aston. That's Upper Sutton Street. And then on the 9th of September, the St. George's Community Forum will be meeting at St. George's Church in Newtown. Now, that's the part of Newtown where you've got the tower, five tower blocks, Schofield Tower, right up to Teviot Tower and Great Hampton Row, Uxbridge Street side. So that will be on September the 9th, and that's 6:30 till 7:30. Also as well, tomorrow evening on Zoom at 7 o'clock, the We Matter public meeting, and that's on Zoom. But a special announcement, go to the We Matter Party Twitter page and Facebook page. The links are there to join the meeting tomorrow. And if you want change, then join We Matter. At least come to the meeting and hear what's being said. Now, importantly, a special announcement with We Matter. Next month, 30th of September, the last Friday, these public meetings are each month, will be the first face-to-face public meeting. And the venues will be announced at the weekend, and you're invited. Make a note of that right now. 7 until 8:30. When we finish at 8:30, there'll be a chance to have tea and coffee. Do put that in your diary from now as well. But one of the things is this evening, it's a shorter than usual one, update. And my apologies for lateness, etc. But we've had a few little technical issues. But what we'll do is, obviously we'll keep the information coming out to you anyway, in the meantime. But before I go into a time of and fellowship, how many of you have had problems getting through to your doctors, your GPs? Let me know. I had a issue getting through to my GP. It's been resolved. And, you know, we have to ensure that we speak up when there is an issue and ensure that that issue is addressed. And I would encourage you, because one thing, our health is important. Just like my health is important as well, our health is important. So if you're struggling to get through to your GP, send a message in and let us do the right thing in terms of moving things forward and standing for what, standing up for what is right. So let us do that. But in the meantime, in closing, we're reminded in Jeremiah 29, and we're reminded from verse 11. For I know the thoughts that I think towards you, says the Lord. Thoughts of peace and not of evil, to give you a future and a hope. Then you will call upon me and go and pray to me, and I will listen to you. And you will seek me and find me. And when you search for me with all your heart, I will be found by you, says the Lord, and I will bring you back from your captivity. I will gather you from all the nations and from all the places where I have driven you, says the Lord, and I will bring you to the place which I cause you to be carried away captive. Trust in God. If you feel you're being tied down, God will free you. But you have to have faith. And we can't give up the fight. My thought of the day today talked about the fact there are times when you hit a brick wall. But it's how you respond to it that makes all the difference. So tonight, as we close in prayer, let me remind you, Sunday the 5th of September will be our face-to-face church services, and that will be at Panelcroft Village in Newtown, in the village hall there. Every Sunday, 11 o'clock, that's our service in Newtown. So do join us. Heavenly Father, thank you for this evening. Thank you for the short time we've spent together. Father God, there were so many obstacles in the way this evening for us doing this. But Father, we know you are the way, the truth, and the light, and we worship, honor, and adore your name right now, Father God. We just want to thank you for bringing us together this evening. And let us just share with one another. And Father, as we fellowship, let us fellowship in spirit and in truth. Father, we know you will deliver us from captivity. And we know, Father, you will place our feet on solid ground. We pray for those who are sick, Father, those who have lost loved ones. We pray, Father God, for those who are caring for the sick, who are caring for the needy. Father, bless, guide, and protect each and every one, we pray right now. Father, lead the way. Father, we just rely upon you right now. And Father, we just ask for your continuous blessing, we pray. Guide and protect us now as we give you thanks in the mighty name of Jesus. Amen. So until Sunday, 11 o'clock, God bless you. And have a wonderful and safe rest of the week in the Lord. The Lord be with you.